Which is why, not to get off the track here, but this is why I always hesitate a little bit when people say, well, God hates slavery. Well, there's slavery elsewhere in the Bible that God seems to condone. The issue here isn't just liberation from slavery. The point here is being God's own people are under the authority of another, and they need to be under the authority of God. So that gets them to Mount Sinai, and that's where the two things happen at Mount Sinai. And the Mount Sinai narrative doesn't end until Numbers. It's all through Leviticus, and then it goes into the first few chapters of Numbers. But two things happen in Exodus. One is they receive law for conduct, both conduct towards God and conduct towards each other. And then it's